Hi there! On this episode, I will build the Trumpeter MiG-23MF Lager B in 48 scale. Let's check what's in the box. Here is a ad about ground targets, instructions about paint schemes. Delicate parts are separated and protected with soft materials. Overall great presentation. Well done, Trumpeter! First of all, I have to say that this kit has changed my mind about Trumpeter kits and Chinese molds. Panel lines, overall details, everything that comes with the kit is just great. Unfortunately, noise cone, air intakes and exhaust area are inaccurate. This photo etch fret is cherry on top. It's a shame like these extras not come with some expensive kits like Zokay Mura. For this build, I bought some detail and correction sets. Metallic details, resin noise cone, ARS correct tail fin, Tech Mode decal set, ARS resin cockpit set and Edward Bixon set for MiG-23MF. First of all, I have to say that this expensive set deserves a better packaging. Please look at that. These chopped sponge pieces say, I have no idea what I'm doing in this box. Look at those bags. They just put in the box without any protection. And this set's price is twice price of the kit. Anyway, all parts are well designed and well detailed, and they fit its places perfectly without any modification, especially this main landing gear wheelbase. This is the first landing gear set I've ever used without any problems. And finally, this is the ARS cockpit set. It has some major fitting problems, but I don't mind that. I love this extremely well detailed set. I will not show you all cutting and cleaning process of the resin parts. Here's a sample how I'm doing that. I always cut resin parts in water to avoid cancerogenic resin dust. I'm starting with modifications on the fuselage hulls before painting the resin cockpit. Liquid glue helps making slots for resin parts on plastic. The resin noise cone fits perfectly, but something wrong with it. Its surface rough like 3D printed part. Look at the surface texture. Let's fix this. But first, I need to cut the fuselage hulls to fit the noise cone. To achieve a smooth surface, I'm using Mr. Surfacer 1200. It's a liquid putty and it fills gaps perfectly. After about 24 hours, I'm sanding the nose cone in water, then I'm rescribing the missing details with a needle. And finally, I'm applying primer to the interior parts. After that, I'm painting the cockpit parts with interior green. I'm painting the cockpit details with Vallejo acrylics. After applying a gloss varnish coat over all the painted surfaces, now it's time to apply the weathering wash. I make my own mixture using wet oil paints and Zippo fluid. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, or if you are not familiar with scale modeling jargon, there are a lot of detailed tutorials and step-by-step build videos on my channel. I recommend one of them. For the link, check the information bar just right side on the screen or the information section of the video. By the way, I'm using Tamiya X22 varnish as a glue for fixing the instrument panels as usual. After applying a matte varnish coat to the cockpit parts, I'm fixing the front landing gear bay to the left fuselage half. And I'm fixing the cockpit to the right fuselage half with 30 minutes epoxy. It's the only thing I trust to fixing big resin parts. I'm setting the landing gear bay in correct position using with cyano acrylate first. After that, I'm applying 30 minutes epoxy. The fuselage is designed in three parts. I'm fixing the lower halves first. The upper fuselage part has contained the wings and the wing mechanism. Also, these parts need some modifications, corrections, and improving the details. Let's see what I did. The wing parts I glued while drying, I am adding noise weights to the noise cone. For that I am using 30 minutes epoxy and lead. Also, I need to paint and fix the exhaust parts to the lower part before closing the upper part. These parts will be barely visible after the fuselage is closed, so I'm painting them with lighter colors than they should be. As I said before, these Edouard resin parts do not require any modifications to fit into place. They are designed according to the kit. That's great, unless that causes inaccuracy problems, and I'm not sure about that. Let's finish the upper part and close it. Despite this complex design, the fitting is quite good. While the fuselage is drying, I'm preparing the air intakes. Edouard recommends use the kit part for the sidewall. That plastic wall will make easier the assembly on the next step. That's exactly what I'm talking about. I'm fixing the air intakes with liquid plastic glue. While the air intakes are drying, I am making a pitot tube using with brass tubes. Now I am sealing resin and plastic connection points using with cyanoacrylate. This is not a shake and bake kit. I was expecting more problems, but it was less than I expected. Let me show you to which points I applied putty and rescribe the details. Of course, all of these are not kids' problems. Some of them are my fault. Let's do some work that will suck the joy out of our soul. Painting canopy frame sealant step by step. This is an obvious detail of MiG-23 canopies. I'm masking and painting the frame step by step. I found this way much easier than making a complex masking. The main landing gear strut connection points were too weak. I strengthened them using with brass rods. I'm attaching the landing gear struts after closing the fuselage, not before like Edouard suggests. This will allow me to make the necessary adjustments if the model tilts to one side. I'm using struts come with the kit as Edouard suggests. It is necessary to add some details to these struts. No level difference. Great! I added brass rods to the front landing gear strut and the tail fin. Then I fixed them to their places with epoxy. Now they are solid. Two missiles come with the Edouard set, R-23R and R-23T. I'll go with T. I need to add brass rod supports to these pylons too. Let's do that. As I said before, a very useful photo etch fret comes with the kit. This piece is from that fret. I'm making some improvements to some small details like this. I'm using white glue to fixing the windshield to its place. Finally, everything is ready to paint. Before that, let's take a look what I did so far. I'm starting paint with the primer application as usual. Then I'm applying the base color according to Tecmod paint scheme. This time I'm applying the white modeling panel by panel instead of random modeling. Now I'm painting dark tones to the edge of details and along the panel lines using MIT Hobby Colors H307. Here is the result so far. Let's blend the effect with highly diluted base color. And here is the result. Before applying the decals, I'm applying my favorite gloss varnish to all painted parts and the model. I will use the Tecmod and the Edward decal sets. The Tecmod decals are extremely thin and delicate. The carrier film of these decals become invisible instantly. Be sure to decal place it correctly before wiping the excess water, otherwise it can be easily damaged. Look at that, it became almost invisible. The other decals are also fine. And I'm painting the remaining details with a brush before the last coat varnish. Again, I made a weathering wash using with oil paints and Zippo fluid, and I am applying that wash to all parts and the model. After the weathering wash dries, I am wiping the excess wash with turpentine. I always paint metallic surfaces last. I never apply any varnish on metallic painted surfaces. I covered the model with papers first, then start the painting. I used Tamiya Clear Orange, Blue and Smoke Acrylic paints respectively to apply the burnt effect. I'm adding the remaining details to the canopy using with white glue. The decals look brand new and not match with the weathering. I'm applying the fade effect on them. And now it's time for my favorite modeling technique, weathering with post shading. And the model is ready to the final assembly. I'm using D3 glue for that. It's a stronger version of white glue. And now I'm adding the remaining micro details. I'm applying the dust effect to the tires using with soft pastel. And it's finished. If you liked the video, please like the video and subscribe to my channel. See you on the next episode. Until then, keep modeling and take care of yourself. Now, enjoy the pictures.